Hi, it's Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and today it's in the mid-70s. It's the 2nd of October. Who'd believe it? Yesterday it was 80 plus, but today we're in the garden, and what we're doing is getting the garden ready for the fall. We still have some fall crops in. These are kale that we've been growing, different kinds of kale, red kale, blue kale, dinosaur kale, which get better and better as the weather gets cooler. We had a screen over this to keep it from burning out in the summer because kale really likes cooler weather. So Rick devised this screening material using our greenhouse fabric, and it served as a shady spot for the kale and other plants that we had growing. Now we need to remove it so that we can get ready for preparing for next spring already. Let me get my tool.
So you just have this in with some basic screws along with some washers just to keep the fabric in place.
Yep.
Easy enough to do and easy enough to replace. And this is drilled into PVC piping.
Right. Let me get this off and then we can see that piping.
And of course we removed the piping too. It just slides out. That way we can get our little rototiller in there and take care of everything.
That wasn't even, oh no. Okay, so there's our PVC. So it's just a matter of slipping that out and then it'll be open just like this one is now. But the real chore that we have today is our tree peonies. Last summer, as some of you may know, we planted, maybe 1,000
yep.
tree peony seeds that we had bought, and waited all summer for them to come up, and they never did, and we were kind of disheartened until an expert in the field, Steve Lau, told us, don't worry, come spring, you'll see that they'll start germinating.
Well, many of them did come. I shouldn't say many, considering we planted 1,000, but quite a few did come up, along with some of the roses that we rose seeds that
right.
we also
These
planted
were
as well.
Exotic roses. So you can see that just in 1 year, these tree peonies, which are not like regular peonies, they actually form bushes that do not die down in the fall. The bush part stays. So some of these have done very well. And now Steve said it's time to take those guys out, put them in their own pots, and any seeds that have not yet germinated could still possibly germinate next spring after they've had the cold winter.
Well, you had to wrap this with a little mesh too to keep our little critters out.
I did. Last fall when it was just the seeds, we were okay and we just put plastic over it and then we buried it under mulched up leaves. Then they started coming up, so we took that off and they were doing perfectly well until a family of chipmunks moved in. And one day I kept coming out here and there'd be all sorts of soil kicked out of the pots, and I'm thinking, what's doing that? So I covered it up thinking it was squirrels. And lo and behold, it was still happening until I saw that it was chipmunks. So then I had to go on a rampage after those chipmunks.
Now you still have 1,000 seeds that we haven't planted. And
I guess,
if I remember correctly, there were like 32 varieties of peony trees and perhaps a dozen different varieties of roses.
Roses, right.
Exotic roses.
Colors and
yeah.
shapes and sizes. So I'm afraid I'm not going to get this all done in one day, obviously. But it's a matter of going through each pot. I've started in these pots. I've put this label over to the side because I felt seeds that were still in there. In these pots where it's in the middle, I couldn't find any seeds left. Those darn little chipmunks ate them all. So now I have to go through and take the ones that are ready to be transplanted and put them in their own pot.
Well, now with the other 1,000 seeds, I think rather than put them in pots, we're just going to reclaim this other section of this raised bed. We do have to get rid of a lot of this soil though, because it's way too high. And one of the mistakes, if you know, that we made was the fact that we really added too much sand, I think, to thinking, well, let's keep the soil friable, very loose. And while the soil is loose, I think it lost a lot of its nutrients over the hot summer days.
Yes, especially last year when we had the drought and then we added sand and it, you know, you would water it and it would still not be moist after you watered it. So that was a sign to us that we went too far one way. So we need to remove some of this anyway in order to make room for the peony seeds. But at the same time, it'll help the soil when we add nutrients to it.
Right. I think we're going to have to get rid of about 4 inches of soil out of this portion of this bed. And I guess temporarily move it someplace else or start another berm someplace else and go from there. So, well, let me put the camera down and help you and get
to
work here.
Okay. Well, I was pulling out a weed. It turned out to be a tree, but not a peony tree, and it was tangled up in the roots of these two peonies. Now look at these. These are beautiful. Look at that new bud that's going to be coming out next spring. And look at those healthy roots. Then there's this little guy who is partially grown. Kind of skinny there in the middle.
Yeah, stick him back in and see what happens.
I will.
Then I have to repot these separately.
I'll just put them in opposite corners.
Like a boxing ring. And in this corner we have... Well, they did grow nicely this year.
You were right,
those
Steve.
Those that grew.
Those that came up very healthy.
Be exciting to see them maybe in about 3-4 years when they really start blossoming, and we'll know exactly which species they are.
Oh, you think so, huh?
Well, I don't know.
Once we see them blossoming,
at least color-wise, we'll have a clue.
We'll know. I believe it was out of this pot. So these are we can't read this one.
Does it have a number?
Red. 23O or 23Q. Yep, this is a red one.
Do you have a space right
now? Right next to it.
Closer, keep coming towards you. More.
Right here.
Right there.
Count. Yep.
Is that empty space?
Yes, it is. Now we'll be mulching these in again with leaves. So it'll be nice and cozy in here.
Give them a little winter blanket.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so these are right next to each other. You know, red is with red.
No, actually it was one away.
This one.
Yeah.
Oh, you're right. Yep.
Oh, well.
We'll know when they blossom.
Yep.
Okay, so we've decided now, after looking at them and looking them over carefully, that we're just going to leave them where they are. They're not that many that are overcrowded right now, and we'll just mulch them in and plant our other seeds over there.
Okay, well, now that we've got the soil down about 4 inches, it's time to start spreading the seeds in some kind of a pattern. I think we're going to get a piece of paper and just kind of generally mark the area so we have an idea where the red ones are, the black ones, the green ones, the purple ones.
Probably a very good idea.
You want to get some paper and pen?
I'll do that.
Okay.
Here's our sheet where we kept track of which were which. And now we're going to grid out this area that we have for them and make a drawing so that we know what we planted where.
Well, we'll also take those large popsicle sticks and we'll put a number to match the numbering system on that piece of paper, also to be our guide. So what's the first one on that list?
Number one, golden yellow peony.
Okay, so let's find that one. Seeing that I don't have my glasses.
Oh, that's just an excuse.
Yeah, well,
Here's four.
And some of these we ended up getting like 40 to 60 seeds from our vendor.
This could take a while.
Yeah. Well, number these have eight. To be organized first, so once we have this, we'll come back and continue.
We've taken a picture of it, and we will also be drawing a little map of the schematic layout of what we have. We're calling this our birth yard here for peony seeds and rose seeds. We put all the roses on the edge.
Well, now it's just a matter of spreading out the seeds kind of evenly, and then we're going to put a thin layer of soil on top, maybe about an inch or
so. About an inch, maybe two.
And then what are you going to do?
Well, then I'd like to put leaf mulch on, but in the meanwhile we have to protect it because this is the time the squirrels are digging everywhere planting their nuts. So we have to make sure that they're not digging in here.
Well, good thing I'm not planting mine. Well, I am. But they're seeds.
There's mosquitoes out here. Where did they come from?
Are they mosquitoes or are they...
No, they're mosquitoes.
Okay. Now you said you're going to keep maybe four of each one?
Mm-hmm, but I have two packages of these, so okay. I have a lot of these.
Well, then just leave one package. Plant that whole package.
Oh, okay, that's a good idea. I'm just going to sprinkle them around and then poke them in.
And then we'll put a little soil on top of this yet.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a lot of poking to do.
Steve, I hope you're not having a heart attack at this strategy we're trying here. Getting these bags open is a trick. Get off of me.
It wasn't me.
I have to go get this. Some spiggies. Okay, well, this is what we've been doing. Just planting away. Pushing them in. Scattering them about. And then we'll put a little bit of soil over the top of them also. Was I putting this one over here too, Rick?
Yes. That's the last one.
And did you save some out of this one?
Yeah, there are two more packages.
Oh, okay. Get an abundance of this kind, in other words.
Yep.
Okay.
So you're just poking them down.
I just am, till I can't see them anymore. Trying to keep each one in its own grid section.
So birth area number 26.
Okay, and the last one.
Birth area number 34.
The nursery right here. I can almost hear them crying in the background.
Wah, wah.
Oh no, that's geese. And then we sprinkled the rose seeds in. These obviously, because they're so small, don't have to go too far under, especially if we sprinkle some soil on top. And we'll sprinkle the soil, we'll water them in, and then we'll have to protect them from those pesky squirrels. Okay, oh, one more. We've got it all mapped out so we know which flower is where, including the roses. Now all that's left to do is just to water it down well and then put a protective shield up so the squirrels aren't digging in here. This would be prime nut hiding area. And then once we get the leaf mulch in, then we will be ready for winter. We have our bed all nice, snug, temporarily covered, so it'll be safe until we can get the leaf mulch on, and then we'll go from there.
And it still gets enough air circulation.
Yes, one whole side is open.
Plus the fact that this is that garden fabric, so when it does rain, and of course it breathes,
right,
so the water can penetrate as well as air.
And the sun.
And the sun, yep. Mm-hmm.
So, should be fine. I don't think we're going to be having a whole lot more 80 degree days. Maybe 2 days from now it's going to be warm, but then it'll immediately turn into a thunder shower. So we should be okay.
Well, nice to have this one done.
Mm-hmm. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. We'd love to hear from you. Any comments or questions? We'll see if we can answer them. Bye for now.